بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، نحمده سبحانه وتعالى ونستهديه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله تعالى من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله تعالى فلا مضل له، ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله وصفيه من خلقه وحبيبه، بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة وكشف الله عز وجل به الغمة وجاهد في سبيل ربه حتى أتاه اليقين. اللهم صلِّ وسلِّم وبارِك عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين، أما بعد. Alhamdulillah, my brothers in Islam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blessed us all with the ni'mah of deen. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala selected us and chose us to be from the ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And Allah further selected us to be from Ahl al-Masjid, the people, my brothers, that worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the house of Allah and keep it alive. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, my brothers, إِنَّمَا يَعْمُرُ مَسَاجِدَ اللَّهِ مَنْ آمَنَ بِاللَّهِ وَالْيَوْمِ الْآخِرِ. Verily it is those that have some belief in Allah and the hereafter that keep the houses of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alive. Alive with the gatherings of deen and the gatherings of iman and the gatherings of the remembrance of Allah. So glad tidings to you, my brothers, for this selection and choice by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Also, my brothers, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala selected us to be from those who are in the time of fitna and fasad and corruption. Alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen, willing after Salah to sit in the gatherings of the remembrance of Allah Azza wa Jal, to remind each other of our deen and what it means to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, my brother, says, وَذَكِّرْ فَإِنَّ الذِّكْرَى تَنْفَعُ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. Remind, because reminders are beneficial for believers. The person speaking and those who are listening, we all need these reminders, my brothers. No one, my brothers, is ghani. No one is rich enough and does not need these reminders. We all need this constant reminder, because the son of Adam, my brothers, is very forgetful, and the test that we are in is very hard. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, my brothers, put us in this dunya. We deal with this dunya day and night. Buy, sell, work, see, sense, communicate, react, act. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants us to disbelieve in this unseen and have full yaqeen and full iman on the unseen. Disbelieve in this seen and have full yaqeen and iman on the unseen. Believing in Allah, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam praises these gatherings so much, because my brothers, they are the key ingredient, the key method to increase iman. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam says in the authentic hadith, when people gather for the remembrance of Allah, like we are gathered now, my brothers, in the house of Allah, the angels keep coming and calling each other, halummu ila hajatikum, come, come, from all of Warsaw, from all of the extended area around this masjid. If we believe in Allah Azza wa Jal and we believe in the promise of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, this is what he is promising. That the angels now, my brothers, as we are talking, if you can see with your heart, not with your eyes, if your heart doesn't have ama, if the heart does not have blindness, as Allah said in the Quran, فَإِنَّهَا لَا تَعْمَ الْأَبْصَارِ وَلَكِنْ تَعْمَ الْقُلُوبُ الَّتِي فِي الصُّدُورِ. It is not the eyes that go blind, it's the hearts that go blind. If our hearts can see, they will be able to see clearly now the angels with us in this gathering and calling each other. هَلُمُّوا إِلَى حَاجَتِكُمْ. An announcement is being made around this gathering, my brothers. The angels are calling onto each other. Come, come. We have found what we are looking for. These angels, as the hadith says, Inna lillahi ta'ala malaikatan sayyara. Angels that roam the roads, searching for these gatherings. That's their job. That's their task. To find these gatherings and come. Yaltamisuna ahla al-dhikr. They are searching for the people of the remembrance of Allah. When they found the gathering, they call unto each other. Come, come. We have found what we are looking for. And then they gather. And then they gather. And then they gather. As the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam tells us in the authentic hadith. This hadith, my brothers, is narrated not in one sahih, in multiple books of sahih. Then they keep gathering and gathering, my brothers, until they reach the clouds. Can you imagine? Can you see with your heart now? Try, my brothers, to see with your heart the promise of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The angels now, my brothers, are accumulating on this gathering until they reach the clouds. And then, my brothers, when this gathering ends by the will of Allah Azza wa Jal, at the end of this gathering, the angels will rise to Allah Azza wa Jal, and Allah will ask them, where did you come from? Where were you? وهو أعلم, Allah knows. But the conversation only happens, why? This conversation narrated in this hadith Qudsi, this conversation that the Prophet ﷺ conveyed to us from the unseen, told us about what we can never know by our senses, only happened for this process, for people to know what Allah Azza wa Jal does. Allah will ask, من أين أتيتم? Where did you come from? The angels will say, my brothers, we came to you from a gathering of your slaves. يحمدونك ويمجدونك. They are praising you and glorifying you and talking about you. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, my brothers, asks a very important question. Allah will say, وَهَلْ رَأَوْنِي. Have these people seen me? The angels will say, لَا وَاللَّهِ يَا رَبِّي مَا رَأَوْك. No, ya Allah, they have never seen me. Anyone here, my brother, saw Allah? What made you come to the masjid to pray and make sajda? You saw Allah before? What made you, my brother, leave money making, entertainment, maybe a game, a soccer game, maybe the gym, maybe time with your family? What made you leave this dunya, come to the house of Allah, pray Isha and sit in the gathering of the remembrance of Allah other than Iman? It's all because of belief. You believe something you can't see. So the angels, my brothers, will say, لا والله يا ربي ما رأوك. No, ya Allah, they have never seen. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, my brothers, will ask, فكيف لو رأوني. How would it be then if they saw me? So the angels, my brothers, will say, oh Allah, if they see you, they will definitely increase in glorification and praise. They will definitely do more of this. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will further ask. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will further ask, what do these people want? وَمَاذَا يَسْأَلُونَ. These slaves of mine, in this gathering that they were in. What were they asking for? What do they want from me? So the angels, my brothers, will say, يَسْأَلُونَكَ الْجَنَّةِ. They want your Jannah. Anyone here, my brothers, wants anything else? Anyone came for any other reason other than the pleasure of Allah and Jannah? So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will then ask again, وَهَلْ رَأَوْهَا. Have they seen this Jannah? Anyone here, my brothers, saw Jannah before? Anyone, my brothers, saw rivers of milk and honey and ماء غير آس وأنهار من خمر لم يت ولذة للشاربين وأنهار من عسل مصفى. Anyone saw the rivers of milk, the rivers of honey in Jannah? Anyone saw the fruit of Jannah? Anyone here from these young men saw Hur al-Ain? That's why he's coming. It's all based on Iman. We all believe in Allah Azza wa Jalla. That's some level of belief that made you come and expect this from Allah Azza wa Jalla. So the angels will say, لا والله يا ربي ما رأوها. No, ya Allah, they have never seen Jannah. So Allah will say, فكيف لو رأوها. Then how would it be if they saw Jannah? My brothers, if one of us sees Jannah, one look, my brothers, into Jannah will make you worship Allah Azza wa Jal constantly without stopping for thousands of years, without hesitation. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows that we are weak because we never saw this Jannah. If we saw this Jannah, Allahu Akbar, who, my brothers, would sacrifice Jannah arduha as-samawat wal-ard because of the rubbish of this world? Who, my brothers, would sacrifice such a sacrifice? Who would make such a stupid investment? Leave Jannah and invest in turab, in the dirt of this world. No one, my brothers. But Allah knows we are weak, and it's all based on faith and iman. Then Allah will ask, what are they afraid of? What are they seeking protection from? So the angels will say, Ya Allah, they are seeking protection from your punishment, Jahannam, hellfire. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will ask, وَهَلْ رَأَوْهَا. Have they seen hellfire? If any of us, my brothers, sees hellfire, by Allah, the thought, not the action, the thought of disobeying Allah Azza wa Jal will be impossible. But the problem is we haven't seen. It's all based on Iman. So the angels will say, oh Allah, if they see hellfire, they'll be more scared. They will never disobey you. Then listen to this carefully, my brothers. Please give me your attention. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will say, فَأُشْهِدُكُمْ يَا مَلَائِكَتِي. Bear witness, my angels, أَنِّي قَدْ غَفَرْتُ لَهُمْ. Bear witness, my angels, that I have forgiven their sins. Not only this, وَأَعْطَيْتُهُمْ مَا يَسْأَلُونَ. And I will give them what they are asking for, which is Jannah. And I will protect them from what they are scared of, which is hellfire. All of this is beautiful and nice. Then the angels will say something ajeeb, gharib. The angels would not be able to hold themselves from further testification. They will say, Ya Allah, fihim abduka fulan. One of them, Allah, please, you know, there's one of them that is a عبدك فلان by name عبد الخطاء. He's a sinner. إنما جاء لحاجة. He never came to remember Allah. He never came to praise Allah. He never came seeking the pleasure of Allah. He came for a different need with a different intention. We all know, my brothers, إنما الأعمال بالنيات. Actions are by intentions. But the angels, when they say this, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will say, وله قد غفرت. Even this sinner that came with a bad intention, I will also forgive him. Why? هم القوم لا يشقى بهم جليسهم. These people, anyone in their company should not be deprived. One of the only a'mal of deen, my brothers, one of the only actions of deen that Allah rewards for, makes the slave benefit from, despite intention. Even salah, if you pray with wrong intention, if you pray with the intention of showing off, what happens? Your salah is rejected. If you do hajj with the wrong intention, your hajj, you say labbaik Allahumma labbaik, the response is la labbaika wa la sa'daika wa hajjuka mardudun alayk. No labbaik and no sa'daik. Get out of here. Your hajj is rejected. The only amal, my brothers, you get rewarded for despite bad intention is this amal. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows that this is the cure. Do you understand why, my brothers? Do you understand why these gatherings Allah Azza wa Jal did not require good intention to benefit from? Because if someone has a sick heart, what's the treatment? If someone has a sick heart, how do we treat him? We say, brother, come to these gatherings. But if benefiting from these gatherings require a clean heart, then يلزمك الدور, you've entered a logical loop. Then what's the point of coming to the gathering if I have to have a good heart? But I don't have a good heart. Because this is shifa, because this is the treatment, Allah Azza wa Jal lifted the condition of good intention. Intention is not required. Just your presence here is enough for Allah Azza wa Jal. You will benefit from this gathering. It's not an easy test, my brothers, to work for something you've never seen. Not easy at all. Don't think it's easy. It's not easy to worship a God you've never seen. Banu Israel, miracle after miracle after miracle. Allah Azza wa Jal opened the ocean for them in front of their eyes. 12 roads on the ocean bed, on the sea bed. The water is hanging in the air like towers. فَكَانَ كُلُّ فِرْقٍ كَالطَّوْضِ الْعَظِيمِ 12 roads for Bani Israel to cross on the bed of the ocean. Not only this, the bed of the ocean is very, very, very moist. It's like a slump. If you step on it, what will happen? You will sink. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala dried the ocean bed for Bani Israel. It was dry for them to cross peacefully. And then as soon as they crossed and Fir'aun and his army followed, Allah drowned Fir'aun and his army. Imagine you live and see this with your eyes. How much iman will you have? How much yaqeen would you have on the power of Allah? وَجَاوَزْنَا بِبَنِي إِسْرَائِيلَ الْبَحْرَ. Allah says, we crossed with Bani Israel, we made them cross the ocean. فَأَتَوْا عَلَىٰ قَوْمٍ يَعْكُفُونَ عَلَىٰ أَصْنَامٍ لَهُمْ. As soon as they crossed, they went past the people worshipping an idol, a stone idol. قَالُوا يَا مُوسَى اجْعَلْ لَنَا إِلَهًا كَمَا لَهُمْ آلِهَةً. Oh Musa, can you please make us a god like these guys? قالوا يا موسى اجعل لنا إلها كما لهم آلهة. They're dying. What do you mean worship something you can't see? What do you mean? Very hard. Can you please have a symbol, a statue of Allah, something, you know, we can worship? اجعل لنا إلها كما لهم آلهة. قال إنكم قوم تجهلون. Ignorant people you are. إن هؤلاء متبر ما هم فيه وباطل ما كانوا يعملون. These people are misguided. Their actions are complete باطل, completely corrupt. But the yearning for the son of Adam to see is unbelievable. This is why eventually Bani Israel, they spilled the beans. They opened the cards to Musa. Said, وقالوا إيه لن نؤمن لك حتى نرى الله جهرا. Look straight up, Musa. We're not going to believe you unless and until we see Allah like this, ayana and bayana. Show us Allah, we'll believe. Very hard. So for someone, my brothers, to worship Allah, work for Jannah, fear hellfire without seeing is very hard. And this, my brothers, is the story of our test. Allah wants us to believe in Him without seeing all of this. Iman. Do you believe me? Do you believe my book? Do you believe my prophet? Yes, O Allah. Jannat arduha as-samawat wal-ard. You doubt? Your iman is weak. Your faith is up and down. Action will not follow. This, my brothers, is the reality of our test. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, my brothers, is the king of the kings. He does not want from us lip service. It's very humiliating. It's very, very disrespectful. It's very disrespectful to claim something with your tongue and not follow by action. Very disrespectful. To say to someone, I believe in you, I love you more than everything, and I love you, Allah. Allah Azza wa Jal does not care one little bit about these words. They mean nothing on Judgment Day. What you say, how you say, doesn't mean anything. Allah Azza wa Jal wants to see proof, evidence. Evidence of your iman. Not coming to see you coming now. You coming here, my brothers, today is not lip service, this is called. That's evidence. Ya Allah, my friends were watching a soccer game. Ya Allah, my friends were at the movies. Ya Allah, other people were, you know, chasing dunya, getting a night shift. Chasing more money. Ya Allah, I left all of this and I spared time for your deen. Tick. A tick beside your name on Judgment Day. This person followed his words by action. What does Allah Azza wa Jal want from us, my brothers? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants us to believe Him, to trust Him, to trust His promise and trust His Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Trust what I say. Ya ayyuha an-nas inna wa'ada Allah haqq. O people, my promise is the truth. Believe me. And Allah Azza wa Jal wants, because of this iman, wants the evidence. And the evidence of iman, my brothers, is sacrifice. Understand this rule, please. The evidence of iman is what? Qurbani. Sacrifice. You believe, you sacrifice. You believe, you spend. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, listen carefully. لَن تَنَالُوا الْبِرَّ حَتَّى تُنْفِقُوا مِمَّا تُحِبُّونَ. You will never ever reach rank with Allah. You will never be promoted. You will never escalate in ranks until you spend from that which you love. Anyone, my brothers, who gives Allah Azza wa Jal something that has no value to him, Allah knows this has no value to you. Anyone, my brothers, who gives sacrifices and makes qurbani with things that are valuable to him, Allah Azza wa Jal rewards him abundantly in dunya and akhirah. Please understand the rule of sacrifice. You sacrifice your time is precious. Two people came today, my brothers. One person was sitting bored at home. He was bored. Couldn't find anything better to do. So he said, you know what, I heard the Australian Jama'ah is in Masjid Al-Farooq. I'm gonna go. They said that there's food after. Will he get reward or not? Like we said, by Allah, he will get reward. But his reward will never ever be equivalent to someone who had something on, was engaged, was busy, has something valuable to do, and left this and then came to the masjid. They are not equal. One has qurbani more than the other. One has sacrifice more than the other. This, my brothers, is the story of our deen. How much are you willing to give Allah? How much? That's the question. That the Sahabi radiallahu anhu, who reached the pleasure of Allah, this man, my brothers, while walking on earth, while on earth, before all of us, until the day we die, my brothers, we are at risk. We are at risk of Allah Azza wa Jal being displeased with us without knowing. Until you meet Allah, you will never know whether you are doing the right things or the wrong things. Allah is happy, pleased, or Allah is not pleased. This man, my brothers, received assurance, received the news while walking on earth. How did he achieve this? How on earth can you get this assurance? People that fear Allah, my brothers, they will die for a sign. Die, you will die for a sign. Any sign. Ya Allah, please, Ya Allah, give me any sign you are pleased with me. There's a way to achieve these signs by big sacrifice. Big and sincere sacrifice. This Sahabi is called Suhaib al-Rumi radiallahu anhu. Suhaib, my brothers, was a Roman slave. Slave that was Roman, not Arab. Captured, sold in Mecca, and lived in Mecca in Jahiliyyah, in the period of severe ignorance, as a slave. Can you imagine the hardship this person is in? Can you imagine that this person does not even own himself? And in which era? Not in a civilized world where maybe rights of slavery are there or something. No. Zero rights. If your owner kills you, there's no problem. Even your life is not yours. This man, in this slavery, in this humiliation, lived in that state for decades. Working very, very hard with his owner. Until he cracked a deal with his owner to free himself by money. I will buy myself out. I'll pay you this amount. Just let me be. The owner loved money. He goes, go work harder. Get me this, you know, get me this amount. He worked day and night in this hardship until he freed himself. Not only freed himself. You're a foreigner in Mecca, dealing with the Quraysh in severe tribalism. Suhaib radiallahu anhu continues to work at tijara, buying, selling, from under zero, from minus. He worked his way out until he became a very rich man in Quraysh. Can you believe it? And then after decades and decades of hard day-to-day work, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam arrives in Mecca and starts giving da'wah. Suhaib radiallahu anhu is influenced. His heart receives the light of da'wah, the light of the Prophet of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So he hides all his wealth somewhere, and then wants to migrate to Rasulullah sallallahu in Medina. The kuffar of Quraysh find out and they chase him. Please, my brothers, don't read seerah like an entertainment story. Read the stories of deen, my brothers. Live it. Put yourself in his position. Compare this man's sacrifice to what I am able and capable of doing. Ask yourself, if I was in this situation, what would I do? Suhaib radiallahu anhu realizes he can't escape them. So he pulls out his arrow and bow. And he stops them. He goes, stop there, at a distance. He says to them, you know that I'm a very good archer. He's outnumbered by far. You know I'm a very good archer. You will probably at the end of the day capture me. But before that, I will definitely take 5-6 of you out. By the time you catch me, there'll be 5-6 deaths amongst you. I will give you a better offer. What's your offer, Ya Suhaib? He goes, I will let you know where all my wealth is hidden. Take all my money, every single dollar, every single gold coin, silver coin, jewelry I've earned in my hard life. Take it all and let me migrate to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The kuffar of Quraysh, they know that his equation is a valid equation. 5-6 of us will die. What do you want from him? We want the money. They're greedy people, they only know dunya. So they say, okay, we agree. They go back to Mecca, they take all his money and they let him go to Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Now this man, my brothers, is traveling to Medina completely broke. Zero. He zeroed his wealth for the sake of Allah. Jibreel comes to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and tells him this story. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam walks to the outskirts of Medina to meet Abu Yahya, to meet Suhaib radiallahu anhu. As soon as he sees him in the horizon, he runs to him. He hugs him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and says what? Look at the words. رَبِحَ الْبَيْعَ أَبَا يَحْيَا رَبِحَ الْبَيْعَ. Oh Abu Yahya, your business was successful. Your business was profitable. Your transaction is a good transaction, a profitable transaction. رَبِحَ الْبَيْعَ أَبَا يَحْيَا رَبِحَ الْبَيْعَ. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reveals Quran. Who knows the ayat? Allah says in the Quran, وَمِنَ النَّاسِ مَنْ يَشْرِي نَفْسَهُ بِتِغَاءَ مَرْضَاتِ اللَّهِ. Some people, they are willing to sacrifice everything, even his nafs, all his wealth, to seek the pleasure of Allah. وَمِنَ النَّاسِ مَنْ يَشْرِي نَفْسَهُ بِتِغَاءَ مَرْضَاتِ اللَّهِ وَاللَّهُ رَؤُوفٌ بِالْعِبَادِ. Some people are willing to give what to Allah? Some people are willing to give everything to Allah. He zeroed his wealth for the sake of Allah. So Allah revealed Quran to praise this man and guarantee him the highest levels of Jannah. Allah acknowledged his sacrifice in this book, in our book, my brothers. When we come to give Allah Azza wa Jal, my brothers, what do we give Allah? Which wealth do we give Allah? Which time do we give Allah? What effort do we give Allah, my brothers? I'll tell you the summary of our life. Sad summary. My brothers, at best, we try to give Allah Azza wa Jal our free time. You know the equation or not? We give Allah what? Our? Free time. What's free time? Any time that is not engaged. Time that has no value. I was probably going to just sleep. You know? We give Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala our free time. Our real time is given to work. Dunya. Business. Money. Children. This we give this the real time. 8 hours a day, no mucking around. 5 or 6 days a week, there is no playing in this time. Rain, hail or shine. If it's raining, if it's snowing, if it's hot, if it's cold, what happens? Bye, I have to work. Pound, pound. Wife needs time. Rajan, Habibat Albi, Juliet. Anything for you. What do you need, Habibti? You need holiday? Take time. You need 1 hour, 2 hour, 3 hour. You tell me whatever your heart pleases. I just don't want trouble at home, please. Just don't turn my life into Jahim, please. Whatever you want. Kids one time, wife one time, work and dunya one time, and then there's time for the gym. The gym also one time. And cricket one time. If India and Pakistan are playing. 90 minutes, I don't know how long the soccer game is. 90 minutes. When soccer first came out in Egypt, you should hear the fatawa of the Mashayikh of Azhar when it first arrived. Haram, waste of time, the Ummah's lost, the Ummah's gone. Who spends 90 minutes watching people chasing a ball? And then slowly, 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 things changed. Now the fatwa is the soccer team can break the fast in Ramadan because they are mujahideen fi sabilillah. As if a sheikh now has the courage to say soccer is haram. Even if he does, he'll end up in jail. What do you mean soccer is haram, you fanatic? We used to think 90 minutes is a waste of time. Then mashallah, we got introduced to cricket. Wallahi al-azim. One whole day. A day match. And then one brother said to me once, Sheikh, what day? Sometimes the game goes on for five days. 5 days watching a ball. 5 days watching a ball, my brothers. Happily, we give cricket 5 days. Happily, 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 you'll give 120 minutes to a movie. Hollywood, Bollywood, sometimes 2 hours. Sometimes 3 hours. Don't worry about this. Sometimes you watch the movie 10 times before. 10 times I've watched the same bloody movie 10 times before. And still I enjoy every bit of it. And still it deserves time. Then what time we give Allah, my brothers? What time do we give Allah? We give Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala our extra time. You know the extra time in the match? The extra time. Brother, are you coming for Isha tonight? Brother, wallahi, I don't want to lie. I can't promise you. I promise you, inshallah, if I can squeeze it between my very, very heavy schedule, I will come. Because he has other priorities. Brother, look, I will try to make it, inshallah. Or I promise Allah Azza wa Jal, that's it. I've had enough of this dunya. MashaAllah, I've lost my life. Shaitan has stolen all my life away from me. This has to change. New plan, inshaAllah. Khair Mus'ab. Khair, MashaAllah, Ali ibn Abi Talib. Khair, ya Umar. What sacrifice you gonna have? InshaAllah, I'm going to do one page of Quran every night before I sleep. MashaAllah, ya Mujahid. Brother, why are you giving so much? No, it's too much now. You might end up in Jannah. Al-one, he wants to give Allah Azza wa Jal 2 minutes. And you're ready to give Allah Azza wa Jal these 2 minutes with quality. You do your Quran when? After everything of dunya took its time. Then we say, Khalas, I'm falling asleep. I have one eye opened, one eye closed. I can't keep my balance. And all right, I promised Allah Azza wa Jal, I'm a soldier. And then you hold the mushaf. You're doing these ones, you know, quickly, Allah A'lam, what you're reading, which surah you're reading, you're reading with tajweed or without tajweed, you know, do you understand the meaning of the Quran or not, brother? We have no time for this. If the Imam in Salah, remember, the movie is 120 minutes on average. If the Imam in Salah dares to make the big gunah, the big crime of reading a bit longer surah in the Quran. What happens, brothers? Wallahi, by Allah, the musallin fight with you. Maulana, what is this? He taps his watch. He goes, brother, what's that? Brother, we have work. Brother, I have to go to my dunya. I didn't, you know, I you know, in Australia we have a lot of Lebanese people, you know, some of the old Lebanese people are very, very funny. So we have a big mosque called La Kimba Mosque in Australia, in Sydney. All, mashallah, the front two rows are old Arab Lebanese, mashallah, soldiers. Old Arab men, you know. So one imam came from Egypt in Ramadan. And ya haram, the imam is sitting in the masjid, no work, no wife, no kids. His only job is what? Salah time comes, just lead salah. So ya haram, the imam is trying, you know, to make, yani, to at least pray properly. So every day, ya haram, this imam is taking his time a bit in salah. Read some Surah Baqarah. No, not long, yani, maybe 15 minutes, you know. Surah Baqarah, Surah Ali Imran, Surah Al-Mu'minun. He's, mashallah, indulging. So one old man stands after a few days. He goes, Shaykh, I have a question for you. He goes to him, Khair, what? He goes, isn't Qul Huwa Allah Ahad in the Quran? In your Quran, there's no Qul Huwa Allah Ahad? In your Quran, there's no Qul A'udhu Bi Rabbil Falaq? Only Baqarah? People can't handle it. Wallahi al-Azim, Wallahi al-Azim, if you're a wali of Allah. If you're a pious man and the imam takes longer, you start getting frustrated in your heart. What's happening, man? What's the imam doing? Why? Because we don't have time for ibadah. We don't have time for Allah. Rather, we want to do other things. You sit in a gathering of deen, the first thing, even in tabligh, even in the masjid, say, Shaykh, you want to give a talk? Yes, please, allow me opportunity. We flew 26 hours from Australia. He goes, look, people of this masjid, inshallah, half an hour. Half an hour. Brother, can't we take a bit longer? Brother, look, anything more than half an hour, you will lose the crowd, man. Why? Because the crowd usually can't give deen more than half an hour. Brother, too much. Brother, we have work, we have wife, we have kids. Maybe you're waiting for a movie tonight. Want to finish this and Netflix has a show on, you know? Beard, abaya, everything. But you know what I mean. He has to, you know, fight for Islam on Facebook. Keyboard warriors. He goes, brother, I have a battle tonight. Where? Uhud, Al-Khandaq? What battle? He goes, brother, I have a massacre tonight. Allahu Akbar, khair. Brother, wallahi, brother, I'm debating some people on Facebook and it has to end tonight, that's it. I am mujahid fi sabilillah. This, my brothers, has become the state of our ummah. We have no time for deen. We want to say to Allah, Ya Allah, I love you. Ya Allah, I worship you. Ya Allah, I want your pleasure. Ya Allah, please be pleased with me. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says to you, okay, my slave, show me, give. What are you going to give? Say, Allah, I'm going to give you half an hour a day. Ya Allah, half an hour a day, Allah. I'm sure you're happy now, huh? You're pleased with me, Allah, now. Half an hour a day. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, لَن تَنَالُوا الْبِرَّ حَتَّى تُنْفِقُوا مِمَّا تُحِبُّونَ. From that which you love. Don't give me your rubbish. Don't give me your extra time. Don't give me the remainder after everything of dunya took its rights and more than its rights. Don't spend 10-15 minutes in the toilet every day and give the Quran 5 minutes and expect you're going to go to Jannah. You're being a fool. You're being a clown. So with time, you have to see, my brothers, every single one of us will meet Allah Azza wa Jal on Judgment Day, and there are numbers, statistics, you know, stats, analytics. Exactly like, you know, the views on your YouTube clip. Statistics. Everyone will meet Allah with a number of hours and weeks and days and months that he spent chasing dunya. And another number that he spent worshipping Allah Azza wa Jal. And I'm telling you, my brothers, these numbers are ridiculous. It's an embarrassing number. It's a disgraceful number at best. Disgraceful, wallahi, by Allah. I heard with these ears my Sheikh saying, if you know someone in our time that dedicates 3 hours a day only for deen, 3 hours properly, quality hours for Allah, he is guaranteed to be a wali of Allah. Just 3 hours a day. I'm telling you, my brothers, it's a very, very hard target. Believe me or don't believe me. 3 hours of quality. Out of 24, you become a wali of Allah. We don't even give Allah Azza wa Jal at best half an hour, I'm telling you. That is, of course, if you exclude the act of prayer that we say, you know. Brother, what do you mean, brother? I come to the masjid. Brother, please, 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 don't talk so that, you know, you don't embarrass yourself. This salah that you claim big, you know, you're getting too happy with, we don't know what is accepted from it. We don't know in this salah, you know, how much of your salah was with concentration and how much with your salah was still in dunya. Physically you're in the masjid, but your heart is where? Solving work problems, dealing with wife, you know. Allah knows, ليس للمرء من صلاته إلا ما عقل منها. And some people, my brothers, because they love Allah Azza wa Jal, like Abu Yahya, Suhaib al-Rumi, they sacrifice all their wealth. How much have you given Allah from your wealth? From your earnings that Allah gave you? The money Allah entrusted you with? How much was spent to please Allah? And how much was spent to please your nafs? And this answers who is your Rabb. Who do you obey? How much of this money was spent to please Allah, a sacrifice with belief for the sake of Allah, and how much of this money was spent to please your wife? Words don't matter, numbers matter. Don't talk. Don't say, brother, wallahi, I love Allah. That's exactly what you're going to be told on Judgment Day. Shut up. Shut this lying mouth. You love Allah more or wife more? Ya Allah, I love you more. Okay, here are the stats. Here are your numbers. Here are your grades. You want to see your marks? Wife. Big house. How much, my brothers? How much is a house in the UK? How much?
200,000.
In Walsall, 300,000. And the wife is happy with that. You can get married with that. She accepts. £300,000. I'm going to say £100,000. Only. Enough. £100,000 you put. You bought a nice house, mashallah, to put a smile on your wife's face. You're getting married, you know, you want to impress. Uncle, give me your daughter's hand. So the uncle looks at you, he says, what qurbani are you going to give me? What kind of qurbani are you going to give? How much dowry? How much mahar? Home, how big is your home? How comfortable? Is it 2 bedroom? Is it 3 bedroom? He says, uncle, I love your daughter so much. You say the number, I'm ready. Did we, my brothers, give anything similar fi sabilillah? Did you give anything similar fi sabilillah? How much money do you spend, mashallah, you know, clothes and gadgets and phone? Your wife, a normal conversation now. Your wife sends you a message. Oh, habibi, I love you, I miss you. So we're in khuruj, you know. We're in khuruj, but we never, khuruj actually now is not khuruj. Khuruj in the past was, you know, seclusion. You leave wife and kids. Now, it's khuruj with mobile dunya. You go on khuruj, you run all your life. Work, business, wife, kids, all online, you know? Everything online. So don't really go khuruj, but we call it khuran, you know? Fi sabilillah qada ma'alash, you know, be nice. Your wife sends you a message. I miss you so much. Oh, I miss you, habibti. Oh, how is the khuruj? Alhamdulillah, khuruj is beautiful. How is your iman? Oh, iman is amazing. Did you know that the new iPhone came out? Have you seen the ad? Now this is a trap message. This is a trap. If you say yes and change the topic, you know what's coming, sah? The new iPhone came out. She's hinting she wants a present. And it's, you're under threat. You either get the phone or Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. Ya haram, what's gonna happen to this miskeen if he doesn't, you know? Pay, pay! Phone, car, keep the wife happy. Okay. Brother, and then we lie to ourselves. Brother, you know why? Wallahi, fi sabilillah. Baba, because you know, who are you lying to? You think Allah Azza wa Jal doesn't know? Brother, no, I'm just shouting her up, fi sabilillah. Brother, no, habib, Allah knows. But how much did you give the poor and the masakeen? How much did you give your brother who is in debt, that desperately needs help? Do you know that with this amount of money that you are happily spending to put a smile on your wife's face, even though the old phone is working perfectly, but it's the old model. It's a shame. How can she walk around with her friends with the old iPhone? How embarrassing. How embarrassing. Do you know that with this money that you're going to spend on a phone, you can feed 10 families in Africa for 3 months? Full. Husband, wife and children, all well fed. But the son of Adam is greedy, and the son of Adam is selfish, and the son of Adam is unempathetic. Doesn't care. Who cares if a million dies from hunger as long as my wife is happy? Deen or no deen? Mawlana or Ammi? You live the life of Israf. Allah Azza wa Jal declares in the Quran that He does not love you. Innahu la yuhibbul musrifin. Your own, I mean, don't worry about Africa, your own brothers and sisters are starving and you are indulging in first world problems. Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. And then we think we're going to meet Allah Azza wa Jal on Judgment Day and prove to Him that, Ya Allah, I loved you and I loved your deen more than dunya. Allah will say, okay, open your books and see. This amount, millions and millions of dollars in your life, millions and millions of pounds you spent on luxury and israf and shahawat and desires. And then there's another very, very, very disgraceful number. The amount of money you gave in charity fi sabilillah. A disgraceful number. Allah Azza wa Jal wants this number, if you have iman, to be a big number, a bigger number than the number of dunya. If you want pleasure of Allah, this is how we prove. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam lived as such. Umar radiallahu anhu, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam once asked the Sahaba for charity. So Umar radiallahu anhu, in this one incident, this is many instances in Umar's life he spent fi sabilillah, but in this one instant, Umar radiallahu anhu had an internal conversation. He goes, you know what? Today, I'm going to beat Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu. So he made a family decision to give the deen of Allah Azza wa Jal half his wealth, half of everything he owns in this dunya. He went to the masjid happy, put the money in front of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Rasulullah sallam asked him, Ya Umar, ma tarakta li ahlika? What have you left for your family? فَقَالَ مِثْلَهُ يَا رَسُولَ, I've left the same amount with my family. The Prophet Allah accepted. Then soon after, Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu comes with everything he owns. Everything he owns. Ya Abu Bakr, what have you left for your family? Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu says, taraktu lahum Allah wa rasulahu. I have left Allah and His Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That's my brother, the difference between weak iman and strong iman. تركت لهم الله ورسوله. I have left Allah and His Prophet. Allah is the Razzaq. Allah will bring. Allah Azza wa Jal, my brothers, does not want us to give what's cheap. Allah wants us to give what is valuable. Why do you think, my brothers, the current work of tabligh is not bringing the right results? Let's be realistic. Jama'at, if I sit in Masjid al-Farooq here and ask you, how many brothers have spent 4 months? Big numbers. How many brothers have spent 40 days? MashaAllah, big numbers. But do you know, brothers, why the deen of Allah has not spread? Do you know why there's no nusra from Allah Azza wa Jal? Because even we spent this time, my brothers, this time was not spent with sacrifice. Once my sheikh, my brothers, went to the UAE, Emirates. They were, mashallah, very, very wealthy people. I remember this, may Allah Azza wa Jal bless his soul. He went there, Khuruj, 4 months in 2001. Thakir Ashkali, he came back from Emirates and he was hot. He was on fire. And he told me himself, I went to the Emirates and I found the work extremely weak. I go, why? I said to him, why do you come? Why is the work weak? He goes, all Emiratis, mashallah, live a very comfortable life. And they all, mashallah, take 6 weeks holidays at the end of the year. Mashallah, many of them, mashallah, they sacrifice these 6 weeks, like the holiday, and they give it to Allah Azza wa Jal for khuruj. So I got confused. I'm a doctor, that's amazing. Ida, they're awliya of Allah. All the holiday every year. So he said to me, Omar, if you go khuruj in the holiday, iman comes in your life. But it will never ever spread in the ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The only way the deen of Allah Azza wa Jal spreads in the world is when you learn how to go khuruj based on the requirement on deen. Of deen, not based on your free time. When deen needs me, I'm ready. Not when I'm free, I give deen. No. This equation is a wrong equation. Sahaba radiallahu anhum did not give bay'ah to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and say, oh Prophet of Allah, we give you bay'ah. What's the deal? When we're free, inshallah, we're with you. When I have a holiday, inshallah, I'm with you. No, my brother. If this was the sacrifice of Sahaba, the deen of Allah would have never left Mecca and Medina. But the Sahaba radiallahu anhum made a different deen. All Sahaba. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam migrated from Mecca to Medina with the Muhajireen. The Muhajireen are ready, you know. They've already sacrificed everything. They left their homes and families and businesses and went to Medina. And then second year, straight away, 2 years after migration, the Battle of Badr comes. The Battle of Badr, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam plans a targeted attack on the caravan of Abu Sufyan coming back from Sham. Because these people stole all our money, we need to, Allah Azza wa Jal gave us permission to attack back and get our money. So the Sahaba radiallahu anhum gather themselves, whoever is ready. 313 of them, unprepared. One horse. One horse. 313 men and one horse. Most Sahaba had no swords, a stick, a rock. And then they're going after what? It still makes sense. Because we're going after 20, 25 soldiers guarding the caravan. You know, let's hijack this caravan. But Allah Azza wa Jal had a different plan. Abu Sufyan finds out, takes a different route, sends a quick messenger to Mecca, and then 1,000 prepared soldiers are coming from Mecca, from Quraysh, to attack the Muslims. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they're outside Medina now. You know, in Medina, they're searching for the caravan. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he's the news. He receives the news. There's an army now coming, 1,000 soldiers. All prepared with the armor and weapons, and they're very, very angry at us. What should we do? Hide, escape, return to Medina. As soon as he asks the Sahaba radiallahu anhu from the Muhajireen, they have no hesitation. Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu stands up. Is that even a question, Ya Rasulullah? Of course we fight fi sabilillah. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam smiles, but no decision is made. So Umar gets up, Ya Rasulullah, as if you're asking, we are fi sabilillah, our lives are for you. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam smiles, and no decision is made. Who speaks, my brothers? Sa'd ibn Mu'adh radiallahu anhu. This man, when he died, my brothers, a few years later, 3 years later, he dies. اهتز لموته عرش الرحمن. The throne of Allah shook for the death of Sa'd radiallahu anhu. Sa'd ibn Mu'adh starts talking. Look at the words. He says to him, O Prophet of Allah, كأنك تعنينا. O Prophet of Allah, are you waiting for the Ansar? The Muhajirin spoke. What's the deal the Ansar made with Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? The covenant, the bay'ah is, O Prophet of Allah, come to Medina, we will protect you in Medina. Now where is the army? They're outside Medina. He can't move on without the permission. This is not part of the bay'ah. So Sa'd radiallahu anhu is shocked. قال كأنك تعنينا يا رسول الله. Are you waiting for us? So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam smiled. What's your response, Ya Sa'd? He goes to him, listen carefully. He goes to him, by Allah, O Prophet of Allah, لا نقول لك كما قالت بنو إسرائيل لموسى. We will not say to you like بنو إسرائيل said to موسى, اذهب أنت وربك فقاتل إنا هنا قاعدون. Go you and your Rabb fight, we're here waiting, you know. بل اذهب وربك فقاتل إنا معكم متبعون. Go bismillah, we are with you. By Allah, O Prophet of Allah, by Allah, take from our money what you want. خذ من أموالنا ما شئت. اذهب بنا حيث شئت. Take us, O Prophet of Allah, wherever you want. If you want now, if you decide that we go to Birak al-Ghamad min the Yemen, if you want us to cross the Death Valley in the south of Saudi Arabia, we will follow you, O Prophet of Allah. Death Valley, we will follow you. He said to him, the money you take from us is more beloved to us than the money you leave with us. We love the money we spend for deen more than the money we save. As soon as Sa'd radiallahu anhu said these words, the Prophet of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said bismillah. And what happened, my brothers? What happens when the son of Adam shows Allah azza wa jal real qurbani? Jibreel alayhi salam sent out 1,000 angels. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent 1,000 angels. Not to win the battle. The battle was won, finished. Allah doesn't need angels. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent 1,000 angels just to strengthen the hearts of Sahaba. وَمَا جَعَلَهُ اللَّهُ إِلَّا بُشْرًا. Just glad tidings for you. Just happiness for you to know that because of your sacrifice, you deserved angels to come down and fight with you fi sabilillah. Once the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to Jibreel, asked him, O Prophet of Allah, ما تعدون أهل بدر فيكم? O Prophet of Allah, what do you consider the people of Badr amongst you? So the Prophet said, they are of the highest strength. Jibreel said, by Allah, even in the angels. The angels that were blessed with joining the battle of Badr are the highest strength. So my brothers, my question to you before blubbering for another hour is, what sacrifice are you going to give Allah Azza wa Jal? Before you die, before you meet Allah Azza wa Jal, what are you going to show Allah that Allah knows, not me, don't care about convincing me, that Allah knows is so valuable to you? Is it going to be time? Is it going to be wealth? Is it going to be your energy, your life, your shabab, your youth? What is it? What are you going to give Allah, my brothers? Everyone has to answer this question alone. And everyone, my brothers, will be questioned by Allah Azza wa Jal alone. Allah will ask you, and these stats are there. Time for deen, time for dunya. Money spent on deen, money spent on dunya. Energy spent on deen, energy spent on dunya. Fikr spent on deen, worry, concern, and fikr spent on dunya. Allah will ask you these questions. This is why, my brothers, we say, please, 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 for the sake of Allah Azza wa Jal, run quickly and go in the path of Allah. Going in the path of Allah, my brothers, is a training ground. No one ever in the world claims that going khuruj fi sabilillah is like jihad. Brothers, there's a huge difference between someone leaving his home, telling his wife goodbye, I may not return, and someone leaving with a return ticket and saying to his wife, Habibti, by Allah, every day 1 hour phone call. Any problem, send me a text, inshallah. I'm here, I'm at your service, please. For the sake of Allah, I've been your slave for 30 years, 40 years. Please give me my freedom for a bit. Let me go work on my deen so I can do something for Akhirah with a return ticket. They will never be equal. Allah knows. But my brothers, still going in the path of Allah is big sacrifice compared to how people are living. That's why we call it the training ground. If I can't give Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala 40 days a year for the deen of Allah, then definitely I can't give Allah Azza wa Jal my life. That's why we ask kindly, brothers, who of you inshallah is ready with iman, with yaqeen, with trust in Allah to sacrifice some time for the sake of Allah Azza wa Jal? Who, my brothers, with iman and belief is ready to spend 4 months as soon as possible? Wallahi al-Azim, it is very little sacrifice. Wallahi. Compared to how we live. Bismillah, stand up, brothers. Bismillah. Whoever is ready for 4 months, and please, everyone, no leave, no one leave the gathering. We finish khalas, 5 minutes. There's also food. Please, bismillah. Innama al-a'malu bil-niyyat. Who is ready for 4 months, my brothers, with sacrifice? Bismillah. MashaAllah, MashaAllah. Yes, brother.
Umar,
4 months. Umar, 4 months, when?
As soon as possible.
Allahu Akbar, which is when? InshaAllah. Sit, make mashura with the brothers, inshaAllah. Abdullah al-Banna, 4 months, MashaAllah. May Allah accept, Ya Rab. Sheikh Ali, MashaAllah. This, my brothers, is the Shaykh that got me on deen. He is the reason why I came on deen, wallahi. I'm not exaggerating. He took me to the masjid for the first time in my life. May Allah Azza wa Jalla reward him, Ya Rabbi. I'm trying to corrupt his intention so that I win the competition. It's not working. MashaAllah, all these young shabab, bismillah. MashaAllah, MashaAllah. MashaAllah, Abdurrahman. What?
The first 42.
4 months? Allah yataqabbal ya Rabbi. My dreams are coming true, my brothers. My son, Abd al-Rahman al-Banna. May Allah Azza wa Jalla accept you, ya Rabbi. My dream is to go for 4 months with me and my boys. All three of them. One day, inshallah. الله يتقبل يا رب. الله أكسب. ما شاء الله ما شاء الله. My brothers, the deen of Allah Azza wa Jal will spread when the youngsters, when the shabab, full of energy, move for the deen of Allah Azza wa Jal. Please, my brothers, move.